So today on Cave Hunters, we have some guests on Norris Lake in eastern Tennessee. We're going to be taking them to two of our favorite caves on this lake, one being Dragon Cave and the other being Spider Falls Cave. We'll probably be on the water for about 8 hours today. Both are great caves. They're both wet caves, which is really normal in the Midwest and the limestone. It'll be a great cave. It should be interesting. We've had a lot of rainfall in the last 3 weeks, so the caves could have a little bit of a different path than we saw before.
We have thunderstorms in the forecast. We don't know how that's going to affect our cave exploration. Off to Spider Falls Cave. Rock on.
Alright, so we're traveling up the Clinch River here. We'll pass by Dragon Cave, which would be right in here. And then we're going to go past that, past the dam, and up to Spider Falls Cave, which should be right in here. Right here is Crawl Cave.
Yeah.
We're heading towards Spider Falls Cave.
Wait, do we want to do Crawl Cave too soon?
I don't know. We'll think about it. Is this illegal what we're doing?
Probably. Another boat down by our boat with like a flood lamp.
We thought it was the cops or nature cops.
Yeah. People were like really concerned.
Either like, oh, that or they wanted to jack our boat.
Yeah, but then they're gonna jack the boat. Jerks.
Well, we just wanted to make sure you're okay.
Yeah, well, crap. Give me my GPS back. I'll cut you off.
What's the Pathfinder say?
We're trying to decide. Alright, we've arrived at the base of Spider Falls, so we're going to do a gear check. Now this is a short-term hike in a wet cave that we know really well, so we don't have a lot of emergency equipment, and we're not going to be in for probably more than 2 hours. So I've got my pack, had this pack for over 10 years, for my best. Got two lines of rope, these are using some descents that we do, but we're not doing anything serious like rappelling, so we don't have any of that kind of gear. A couple of knee pads. It's really important in these caves to always pack water. Because you're in a wet cave, you don't realize how much you're sweating and how dehydrated you can actually get from all the physical activity. So it's important to keep consuming water. Got a couple of gloves. Always important first aid kit. Absolutely essential. And then plenty of backup lights. I carry two headlamps and two hand lights, always. And a backup pack of batteries. Mentioned earlier, you always want to at least leave a note, call, text. Somebody let them know your plans, when you're supposed to be back. So let's go. All right, we're about to start our ascent up to Spider Falls. You can see there's the half of its name. We'll save the other half when we get there. There's a quick climb up the waterfall, and then we'll be up in the mouth of the cave. See if you smell anything yet? Almost. See ya.
I'm gonna try going up the left way. I'm gonna try to do the log.
Finish the ascent to Spider Falls camp. Got an entrance. You can see the waterfall's about an 80-foot drop. It's just a guesstimate. We're gonna climb it. You can tell from the stratum of form, Acacians. The cave's around 6 million years old. This is typically, like, again, what a T-Rex would live in. It's pretty normal. So we'll see if we can find any other flippers inside the pit. The second half of waterfall Spider Falls is filled with big spiders. We've got our little friend right down here. Can you get a shot of him?
No.
Yeah. Dethicus arachnus.
Not as many. Not nearly as many.
Oh, this is tight!
It's awesome.
I got $10 on him dying.
I want that bet too, though.
I'll raise you $6. Now reach the entrance to Dragon Cave, which you'll see here soon. Why it's named Dragon Cave, because if a dragon was to live anywhere, this lake could be here. The gate to Dragon Cave is barred shut. Luckily the top bar has been soldered off though, so you can weasel through there. Last thing I came to Dragon Cave, took a bite out of my arm right there. You see the scar? It's not gonna take a bite out this time though. Steve, what are your thoughts?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. Steve, what do you got there?
This is a snake, dude. He's awesome.
Where'd you find him?
I found him right inside the entrance to Dragon Cave. He's probably the guardian.
Once inside Dragon Cave, there's about a 7-foot tall metal wall. There's about a foot opening at the top, though, that you can kind of just
just get through. So we're ascending that now. Okay, so we're on a shelf on the right side of the tunnel backwards, and in the middle is this channel of water. It's about 4 feet deep. Can't really see it on the camera very well. And we occasionally have to cross over because we run out of land, like we will before too long. We've come around a corner and the passage has gotten maybe, what would you guys say, 40 feet high?
Yeah,
50 or 60 feet high. It's fantastic. It's amazing. Look at that. Roughly an hour and a half later, we emerge from Dragon Cave. An amazing adventure. New passages found. More to be recapped tonight. And the conclusion of Cave Hunters.